Hello everyone and welcome to We, Women Empowered, being brought to you by Radio Fundu. Women Empowered is a network through radio and social media to connect women of all walks of life to inspire and motivate each other to succeed in their personal, social and professional goals. Visit www.wenetworkonline.socialgo.com and you can also find us on Facebook as We Network Online. I'm your host, Rennu Dhillon, and today we celebrate International Women's Day for the next 30 minutes. International Women's Day has been observed since the early 1900s, a time of great expansion and turbulence in the industrialized world that saw booming population growth and the rise of radical ideologies. International Women's Day, originally called International Working Women's Day, is marked on March the 8th every year. Nowadays, this is a major day of global celebration of women. In different regions, the focus of the celebrations ranges from the general celebration of respect, appreciation and love towards women to a celebration for women's economic, political and social achievements. Started as a socialist political event, the holiday blended in the culture of many countries, primarily Eastern Europe, Russia and the former Soviet bloc. In many regions, the day lost its political flavor and became simply an occasion for men to express their love for women in a way somewhat similar to a mixture of Mother's Day and St. Valentine's Day. In other regions, however, the original political and human rights theme designated by the United Nations runs strong, and political and social awareness of the struggles of women worldwide are brought out and examined in a hopeful manner. We will be right back after these messages from our sponsor. And again, I'm your host, Rennu Dhillon, to empower all the women for the next 30 minutes. Where can you find Indian cuisine packed with flavor and the liberal use of organic vegetables, fresh or natural halal chicken and free-range grass-fed halal lamb? Where can you find Indian cuisine serving fresh, innovative and high-quality Indian food at affordable prices? Where can you find Indian cuisine served with a variety of beverages that do not contain HFCS? Committed to serving innovative and high-quality Indian food, offering a range of tantalizing layers of flavors in a matter of minutes, then you need to go to Chaat Cafe. With convenient locations in Fremont, San Jose, Berkeley and San Francisco, visit chaatcafe.com. Since 1999, the Mahal family has been sharing their passion for Indian cooking with the Bay Area community. If you are seeking that quick curry for an easy weeknight meal or a medley of dishes for an Indian-themed dinner party or grabbing their quick lunch or dinner, then Chaat Cafe is your answer. Visit Chaat Cafe today. Fast, fresh and casual. Does your auto insurance meet your needs? Are you happy with your current insurance company or would you like to find some comparable rates? Then call Jatinder Pankar. Jatinder Pankar is a farmer's insurance agent who can review your car insurance coverage, help you identify potential gaps and let you know about any farmer's auto insurance discounts for which you may qualify. Call Jatinder today at 510-673-3635. That's 510-673-3635 for a no obligation quote. Jatinder is known for his prompt friendly service. Call 510-673-3635 or email jpankar@farmersagent.com. Do you know what genius means? The original meaning of genius means to give birth to joy, and that is within each child as related to the word Genesis. Every child comes into life with wonder, curiosity, spontaneity, flexibility and many other joyful qualities. It is imperative that as educators and parents we help preserve these genius qualities of children as they mature into adulthood. And this is exactly what we do at the Little Genius Kid. A brand new center and the very first franchise of Genius Kids open in San Ramon, our vision is tender loving care to think, lead and communicate. Our goal is to provide high standards of education in creative, fun classrooms and dedicate our unique accelerated learning methods to developing leaders of tomorrow. Targeting age groups 2 to 12, call 925-244-1080. That's 925-244-1080 or visit thelittlegeniuskid.com. That's thelilgeniuskid.com. No matter what the future holds, learning the importance of public speaking is a skill that will help every single one, children and adults. Communication skills remain high in the list of proficiencies that employers expect employees to master. By introducing your child at a young age to public speaking, you will give them a variety of experiences and build their self-confidence. Call Rennu Dhillon at 510-364-4033 for classes for adults and children. Remember, public speaking opportunities are a great way for anyone to build their self-confidence and overcome any fear of speaking in front of a group. Call Rennu Dhillon at 510-364-4033. This is We Women Empowered, which is a network through radio and social media to connect women of all walks of life to inspire and motivate each other to succeed in their personal, social and professional goals. I'm your host, Rennu Dhillon. Since yesterday, many of us have been hearing about International Women's Day being celebrated around the world. But how many of us really know the reason why we celebrate this day? I thought I would spend a few minutes empowering your neurons on some facts. In 1975, the United Nations proclaimed March the 8th to be the day on which women around the world should commemorate their struggles and celebrate their achievements. But its history actually goes back more than a century before that day. In 1857, women garment workers in New York staged a massive street protest about the 12-hour workdays, poverty wages, and sexual harassment that was common in their jobs. 51 years later, they held the same massive demonstration in New York, adding the problems of the lack of women's suffrage and continuing child labor to the list of women's burdens. In 1910, women in 17 countries attended the Conference of Socialist Women in Denmark, vote to establish an International Women's Day in March. Continuing outrage at the plight of women, fueled by the tragic loss of young women in the Triangle Shirtwaist Factory Fire of 1911 and the textile workers' strike in 1912 that inspired the song Bread and Roses, bread symbolizing wages and roses the quality of life, helped to create a common bond across countries and industries for women workers. March the 8th became known as the day that marks women's efforts to attain justice and equality for themselves and their children. So now let's take a moment to recognize some of the most amazing women in India who have made a difference in the lives of others. Starting in 1883, Chandramukhi Basu and Kadambini Ganguly became the first female graduates of India and the British Empire. In 1886, these young ladies then continued to become the first women from India to be trained in Western medicine, to include Anandji Gopal Joshi. In 1905, Suzanne R.D. Tata became the first Indian woman to drive a car. In 1916, the first women's university, SDNT Women's University, was founded on June the 2nd by the social reformer Dondo Keshav Karve with just 5 students. In 1917, Annie Besant became the first female president of the Indian National Congress. In 1925, Sarojini Naidu became the first Indian-born female president of the Indian National Congress. Continuing, in 1947, on August 15th, following independence, Sarojini Naidu became the governor of the United Provinces and in the process became India's first woman governor. In 1959, Anna Chandy became the first Indian woman judge of the High Court in the Kerala High Court. In 1966, Captain Durga Banerjee becomes the first Indian woman pilot of the state airline Indian Airlines. In 1966, Indira Gandhi becomes the first woman Prime Minister of India. In 1970, Kamaljeet Sandhu becomes the first Indian woman to win a gold in the Asian Games. And let's not forget, in 1972, Kiran Bedi becomes the first female recruit to join the Indian Police Service. Mother Teresa, of course, won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1979, becoming the first Indian female citizen to do so. In 1989, Justice M. Fatima Bibi becomes the first woman judge of the Supreme Court of India. And then, of course, in 1997, Kalpana Chawla becomes the first Indian-born woman to go into space. 1992, Priya Jinga becomes the first lady cadet to join the Indian Army, later commissioned on March 6, 1993. In 2000, Karna Malaswari becomes the first Indian woman to win an Olympic medal, bronze medal, in the 2000 Summer Olympics at Sydney. In 2002, Lakshmi Sehgal becomes the first Indian woman to run for the post of President of India. 2004, Punita Arora becomes the first woman in the Indian Army to don the highest rank of Lieutenant General. 2007, Pratibha Patil becomes the first woman President of India. And then, of course, in 2009, Meera Kumar becomes the first woman Speaker of the Lok Sabha, the lower house in Indian Parliament. Ladies, let's honor and remember these women. We'll be right back after these messages. Reading is the foundation and basis of all learning. Facts show that children and teenagers who love reading have comparatively higher IQs. The more creative they are and the better they do in school and college. The habit of reading also helps readers to decipher new words and phrases that come across in everyday conversation. Reading provides a productive approach to improving vocabulary and word power. However, California remains at the bottom of the barrel in the national test scores for reading, sharing last place with Louisiana, Arizona, New Mexico, and Washington, D.C. The state's reading scores have remained flat since the last assessment in 2007. And with the recent budget cuts in school, parents, don't hold your breath for better results. You need to bring your child to the 3 R's Club, which is part of the Little Genius Kid. The 3 R's Club is Read, Respond, and Reiterate, where your child can attend reading classes and reading books to practice reading fluently, comprehension, reiteration, and voice inflection and expression, building an extensive vocabulary and love for reading and speaking. Memberships start from only $100 a month. We target preschool, pre-K, kindergarten, and grades kindergarten through to 6th grade. Call 510-445-0197. That's 510-445-0197 for more information on the 3 R's Club.
How many of you hate going to the gym? Maybe you are too embarrassed to work out in front of so many people. Maybe you have kids and cannot find someone to take care of them for a couple of hours a week. Maybe you are just confused with all of the complicated equipment you are seeing in the gym and need a simple and easy solution. Well, worry no further. Call Karen Dhillon and have your own personal trainer. Karen offers personal training in the comforts of your own house or in a small groups. Affordable and easy. Wait no more and get into shape for spring and summer. Call Karen today for a free consultation at 408-564-9060. 408-564-9060.
Where can you find Indian cuisine packed with flavor and the liberal use of organic vegetables, fresh or natural halal chicken and free-range grass-fed halal lamb? Where can you find Indian cuisine serving fresh, innovative and high-quality Indian food at affordable prices? Where can you find Indian cuisine served with a variety of beverages that do not contain HFCS? Committed to serving innovative and high-quality Indian food, offering a range of tantalizing layers of flavors in a matter of minutes, then you need to go to Chaat Cafe. With convenient locations in Fremont, San Jose, Berkeley, and San Francisco, visit chaatcafe.com. Since 1999, the Mahal family has been sharing their passion for Indian cooking with the Bay Area community. If you are seeking that quick curry for an easy weeknight meal or a medley of dishes for an Indian-themed dinner party or grabbing that quick lunch or dinner, then Chaat Cafe is your answer. Visit Chaat Cafe today. Fast, fresh and casual. We know it is difficult to imagine a time when you won't be there to help provide for your family. This is why Farmers Insurance has developed a suite of life insurance products designed to help answer your life insurance requirements at any stage of life. Whether you're a new family, empty nester, business owner or a single parent, you need to call Jitinder Prankar today at 510-673-3635. That's 510-673-3635. Farmers has a life insurance option to suit your needs and budget. For a personalized assessment of your life insurance needs, give Jitinder a call at 510-673-3635. Do you know of any children that are talented? Children that can draw, paint, tell jokes, dance, do mimicry, magic tricks, or maybe even their pet can do some tricks. Anything amazing and unusual? Well, Spandana's Got Talent is seeking that child. This is a chance for that child to showcase their talent and art at a premier show on March the 19th, 2011 at the Windermere Ranch Middle School in San Ramon. Visit www.spandana.org. That's spandana.org or call Giri Prasad at 201-606-3949. Don't miss this opportunity to showcase your talent and be part of a non-profit organization to make a difference in the lives of others. Give Mr. Giri Prasad a call at 201-606-3949. Social media networking is quickly becoming a powerful marketing and branding strategy for all businesses around the globe. It is critical to create awareness for your services and products and have a system of receiving feedback to improve your offerings. All businesses are embarking into implementing social media to streamline their sales, marketing, public relations and customer service to energize their business online. But how do you find the time to do all this when you're too busy with your day-to-day operations? Then you need the services of Sheetal Ori. Sheetal is a result-driven business development entrepreneur, having 17 years of experience in the hotels, restaurants, travel and IT industry with PR, sales and event management as her forte. She also provides consultancy in establishing and fundraising for non-profit organizations and small business owners and startups. Call Sheetal today at 415-505-9592. That's 415-505-9592 or visit her website at www.sheetalori.com. That's Sheetal, S-H-E-E-T-A-L, Ori, O-H-R-I.com for more information. Hello everyone and welcome back. And for those who've just tuned in, this is We Women Empowered, which is a network through radio and social media to connect women of all walks of life to inspire and motivate each other to succeed. I'm your host, Rennu Dhillon, and I'm empowering each and every one of you for the next 30 minutes. Today, we're talking about why we celebrate International Women's Day and we're honoring and recognizing women around the world. Let's begin with this statement. The origin of a child is a mother, a woman. She shows a man what loving, caring and sharing is all about. This statement was said by Sushmita Sen, India's first Miss Universe, in the final round of the contest, an answer which was greeted with tremendous applause and which probably led her to win the crown. Indeed, a woman's essence lies in her innate ability to care, love and sacrifice for the other. She plays an all-enveloping character of a mother, daughter, wife and sister, as a friend, nurturer, guide and partner from time to time. Emotional and vulnerable, sometimes erratic, sometimes serene, a woman displays a wonderful range of emotions from being patient to being extremely courageous in times of crisis. Tormented and subjugated through all times and ages, women have fought their way through exploitation, harassment, and have managed to secure their rights in the public domain. In spite of continuing exploitation and injustice against women, both in the domestic and work sector today, several milestones have been achieved in terms of education, freedom of choice, and liberty and equality. With growing literacy and financial independence, women feel more empowered today to assert their right to a life of dignity and self-worth. Hence, the International Women's Day, celebrated on 8th of March, is a universal day for all women around the world. It endows them, which is us, with a sense of honor, dignity and self-respect for being the person that we are. This day marks a celebration of the economic, social, cultural and political achievements made by women over the years. However, let's wake up and face reality. Have women really achieved the equal status in India that we deserve? If so, then why are there so many organizations still opening to help domestic violence victims, especially women? And why was it necessary for a walk to be hosted in San Francisco over the weekend and around the world for missing girls in India? Why are women still being subjected to abuse, especially when we do not give birth to sons? Although women in India now participate in all activities such as education, sports, politics, media, art and culture, service sectors, science and technology, are we really being treated equally? The Constitution of India guarantees to all Indian women equality, Article 14, no discrimination by the state, Article 15, equality of opportunity, Article 16, equal pay for equal work, Article 39. In addition, it allows special provisions to be made by the state in favor of women and children, Article 15.3. Renouncing practices derogatory to the dignity of women, Article 51, and also allows for provisions to be made by the state for securing just and humane conditions of work and for maternity relief, Article 42. But ladies, Let's ask ourselves truly and honestly, is this really being practiced? How about each of us women who have sons and daughters? Are you really treating them equally? On that note, I'll be right back after these messages. Do you love talking? Are you opinionated, passionate and charming with screen presence and poise? Have you always wished to be a TV host and personality? Well, this is your chance. Indiva 2011, being brought to you by Rennu Dhillon, is produced in collaboration with Women Now TV and Sheetal Ori and our exclusive media sponsor Radio Fundu. Indiva is that platform for the South Asian woman who seeks to be the face and voice of tomorrow. The winner of the event will become the co-host of the Voice for the Bay Area Women Now TV show, which is www.womennow.tv, and an opportunity to host TV Asia programming as well. TV Asia is the first coast-to-coast entertainment and informational channel for the South Asian community settled in the United States. The competition is open to South Asian women ages 18+. Age is no limit, single, married or divorced, who is a legal U.S. resident. The winner may be from any part of the United States. We have a special segment called the Young Ambassadors Award. We understand and appreciate that there are many young aspiring teens who wish to be on media and television, and this segment is open to teens ages 15 to under 18. The winner will be the Young Ambassador for Women Now TV show in their own city or state of residence and will cover important topics there. For more information, call Rennu at 510-364-4033. That's 510-364-4033. Akshaya Patra is the world's largest NGO-run midday meal program, serving over 1.2 million children daily in 8 states in India. Akshaya Patra Foundation is a registered 501c organization in the United States. Akshaya Patra needs your help. They want to reach out to over 5 million children by 2020, and they can only do this with a simple donation from you. $30 a year can make a difference in one child. Visit www.akshayapatra.org and make a difference. 50 million girls have been eliminated from India's population in the last century. 10 million girls have been killed by their parents either before or immediately after birth in the last two decades. The average ratio of women to men is 927 to 1,000 based on the last census in 2001. And in some parts of North India, it is as low as 750 women to 1,000 men. This needs to stop, and it needs to stop today. Please call Naina at 415-823-4429 for more information. That's 415-823-4429. Or you can visit www.petalsinthedust.com. That's PETALS in the dust.com. Andaz Television on Sony Entertainment Television and Genius Kids presents Discovering Shining Stars, a talent competition for children and a parenting fair on Sunday, May the 1st, 2011, right here at the Global School of Silicon Valley in San Jose from 10 o'clock in the morning to 5 o'clock p.m. Seeking young, talented boys and girls ages 5 to 12 for three categories, singing, dancing and public speaking. The winner in each category will be featured on Andaz Television on Sony Entertainment Television worldwide. Vendor booths, talent coaching, karaoke, parenting workshops, entertainment prizes and lots more. Free event open to the public. To register your child for the competition, please call 415-742-2842 or email events@andaztv.com. That's andaaztv.com or call 510-364-4033. For a vendor booth information, please call 415-742-2842. Early bird registration is only $250. Don't forget this incredible opportunity. Your child could be the next superstar on Andaz Television, Sony Entertainment Television. Described as a classroom for the future, a school that shapes tomorrow's citizens. Nominated Best Preschool in Alameda County and winning Best Educational Services Most Likely Place to Find a Silicon Valley Inventor. And now selected by CNN Money and Time Warner as one of the 6 most innovative and inspirational companies in the country. Genius Kids is now an official franchise. opening its first franchise in San Ramon at the Bishop Ranch on February 1, 2011. The Little Genius Kid franchise offers an exciting and innovative business model that is easy and rewarding. Call 1-888-LIL-Genius. That's 1-888-LITTLE-GENIUS or 510-364-4033 for more information. Give your child a gift of a lifetime, the ability to read, think, and communicate at a young age. Only at Genius Kids. Visit www.geniuskidsonline.com or call 510-364-4033. It brings me to the end of our show, and thank you for tuning in to We Women Empowered, being brought to you by Rennu Dhillon. I'm thrilled to empower all the women every Wednesdays from 10:30 to 11 o'clock in the morning. Remember, women's empowerment is vital to sustainable development and the realization of human rights for all. We believe that every woman is a full circle with the power to create, nurture, and transform. As Nancy Pelosi once said, women are leaders everywhere you look, from the CEO who runs a Fortune 500 company to the housewife who raises her children and heads her household. Our country was built by strong women, and we will continue to break down walls and defy stereotypes. All my listeners who are listening in, thank you so much and happy International Women's Day to all of you. And I'll leave you with this song from one of my favorite movies, Subeda.
Thank you.